In this video, I will explain video track assignment using the patch panel. The patch panel, located to the left of the sequence, represents source tracks and destination tracks. You will recognize the layout similar to other editors. However, operating the patch panel may be slightly different from what you've previously used. Let's first examine what all the tabs mean. The dark gray tabs represent the tracks in the sequence. The description in each tab tells you what the track represents. In the case of the video tabs, they all have a version number and a layer number. You can have multiple versions of your edit in the sequence, but most people usually just stick to one to keep things uncomplicated. That is why all the video tabs start with a V1. The 1, 2, and ascending numbering after the video version represent tracks or layers in the sequence. Layer 1 is always the bottom layer, and the other layers stack on top. When you rearrange the layers, the track tabs will update accordingly. The green tabs are source assignments. So a source has been loaded into the source viewer, and its video will be assigned via the green tab to the appropriate video track in the active sequence. You click on tabs to connect or disconnect them. When the two tabs are connected together, Smoke will edit the source clip onto the assigned destination track. Clicking on one tab connects or disconnects it to its corresponding destination track. Shift-clicking a tab connects or disconnects all video tabs. Now, coming from another NLE, you might be used to different methods of patching your source tabs to your desired destination tracks. Smoke gives you a few options to do this, and I'm sure you'll find your favorite. Firstly, you can simply drag a video source tab between video tracks. The tab will automatically patch to that track, and your media will be edited here. Now, this is pretty obvious, but something I would like to point out. You can see the source tab is patched to a particular video track. You can also see that the focus point on the positioner is also assigned to the same track. These are actually tied together. When you move the focus point up or down, the source tab will follow after it. You can do this with the page up and page down keyboard shortcuts. It is different from what you are used to, but there are other significant benefits. When editing in the sequence, your attention is typically focused on where you are working. So by watching the focus point on the positioner, you know exactly where your video will be edited and onto which video track of the sequence. Another option for patching the source tabs is to use the video track indicator boxes in the patch panel. These boxes normally tell which track you are currently viewing and all the tracks below. But it also acts as a switcher for video patching, and this also moves the focus point. And finally, you can right-click on any track and you will find track patching in the pop-up menu. Using the submenu, you can choose to assign a source tab or clear the source tab assignment on the specific track. These methods of video patching will hopefully get you assigning tracks fast and efficiently. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.